Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
All right, Tristan, difficult time right now, probably for you and your family, as the Hurricane Isaac's running through the region again. What's kind of going through your mind right now?
Well, I just hope everybody's safe. You know, I talked to my dad and my mom last night. They haven't hit yet, but it's supposed to hit early this morning. I called this morning, but I haven't gotten in touch with anybody, so I'm going to get on the phone as soon as I get out of here.
Is your family staying at home?
Yes, sir. They stayed at home. Hopefully it didn't get too bad, but I got to call and see. I was watching the news all last night, but I hope it's not like Hurricane Katrina.
Is it difficult being so far away right now?
Oh, yes, sir. It's definitely tough times, you know, but it's part of football. All I can do is just hope and pray.
What happened to your family through Katrina then? Because it's kind of weird that it's been exactly pretty much 7 years to the day.
Actually, we just got a bunch of trees and stuff out. Nothing fell in the houses or the cars. We didn't have lights for like 3 weeks. And so that was like the bad part. But we stuck together. It kind of made me look at life a little different, you know. Just the small things in life, you know. So I just don't want to go through that again, you know.
Were you at home then?
Oh, yes, sir. I was a sophomore in college. I was in junior college then. So they sent us home. By the time I got home, Katrina had hit.
What was that experience like?
Oh, man, the worst experience ever. I wouldn't even wish it on my worst enemy. You know, it's tough, man. And then during that time, it was hot, too. No air. All the food ruined. You had to sit in the gas lines for 6 hours $15 gas, you know, case of water and a bag of ice, and that's all you get. And we had to use the water to drink and bathe with. It was just tough.
You got a few other guys on the team, Milt Collins, Odell Willis, also from that area. Are you guys kind of sticking together right now?
Oh, yeah. Me and Milton, actually, me and Milton are really close. You know, we went to junior college together. We was together during the Katrina, too. So, it was a pretty tough time. I watched New Orleans. It was pretty bad there last night. And I know he really worried because he hit them really bad. And I know they can't withhold another storm like that. But so far, they said the levee is holding right now.
What goes on in the city? What goes on in the state itself when these hurricanes blow in?
That's when all the violence and the stealing and everything is like, you give those people that kills and steals, they give them leeway because the hurricane coming, there's just nobody there just to stop them. So people just gonna keep on doing it. So it's kind of crazy right now.
Have you been in contact with anyone down there?
I talked to my mom, my sisters, but it's scary right now because, last time everybody waited to see what it was going to do. But, our New Orleans ain't really all the way built back up for us to just be like, you know, we'll stay around and wait. So I'm just waiting to hear back from them today to let me know how everything went.
Do you know if they left town or not?
Nah. My mom and them didn't leave town because last time we left town, like, some of our stuff got stolen now. So just trying to just hold it out. Tell us they have to leave. So that's when they'll leave.
Do you mind when you see that going on in your...
Just that, you know, what goes through my mind is just, you know what I'm saying, just losing friends and family like I did before. But I said if it hit hard again, it's no more New Orleans because New Orleans is already bad as it is right now. So, I just hope it ain't as bad, I'm saying, when I get back down there. So that's all.
Is it difficult being so far away from there right now?
Very difficult because, I'm the only man in my family. It's just my mom and my sister. So it's very difficult, but they'll hold strong for me.